The Gear S offers a lot of flexibility to enhance the user experience with rich notification. Hi, I'm Vincent, one of the developers here at Samsung. In our last episode, the basics of rich notification, which has enhanced stability and better performance, was introduced. In this second part, we will look into creating an advanced rich notification sample application. In the last episode, the rich notification has many features that the developer can use to create applications that are easy to use, which makes use of brand content and personalization have an edge with effective user interface. User experience is one of the highlights of this SDK, making sure that action interfaces are easy to use. Templates and structures are key guidelines to make an effective visual and content layout to make the experience more immersive. Right, let's get to it. We made Hello Rich Notification last time. Now we will create an application more complex. This walkthrough will show how rich notification can be used in many combinations and personalizations to cater to whatever specifications that needs to be. This may be used as a base guide to creating your very own rich notification app. To create the rich notification of your own, we would need, first, the utilities. Now, this includes the Eclipse with ADT plugin, the rich notification library, an Android smartphone, and for this example, we will use the Galaxy S5, Gear Manager 2.2, and of course, the Samsung Gear S. Now, as an option, you can use the Remote Test Lab or RTL found in the developer.samsung.com if you don't have a Samsung Gear S. Let's start creating our app. The first action in this list is implied as the primary action for the notification. Let's try out the first type, the host action. Go ahead and provide an instance and call it whatever you like. I'll put in call mothership, since we are trying to reach our host device. How about we place an icon over here? And provide a toast set to appear if it's successful. Since we are trying to reach our host, we're going to set up an intent referring to this class itself and set its callback. To finalize this action, we need to add it to our list. So this action calls for the current intent, which would send another notification to our device. Succeeding actions added to the list are just part of the More Options button. after the host action, we can try out the remote launcher. Like in the host action, we instantiate it and give it a name. Both actions launch an application. Difference is, the remote launch action opens an application in the wearable device. To specify the app that we want to launch, let's set the operation to the given operation name of the Tizen app. Don't forget to add it to our list of actions. Now let's make use of the built-in functions, namely call and SMS. Instantiate a variable of type SRN remote built-in action and provide a name for it. Set its operation type to call. To specify the number we are trying to call, we set the data like this. Again, we add it to our list. As for SMS or text, we copy this and change call to SMS. Now that we have experience using the SMS, we now try to get an input using a keyboard. Instantiate an SRN remote input action and provide default settings from specifying the requested input mode. Here, we can place a prefill string, character limit, and the keyboard type. Like all others, let's add it to the list of actions that we have. Now that we placed all of these actions into our notification, it's time to launch it to our device and see our actions in one blow. Let's test the application out. On the screen, we see a Galaxy S5 and a Gear S. When you run the application, this would call the rich notification from the Galaxy S5 to the Gear S. On the lower right corner of the Gear S, we see a round icon with three squares. This button would contain further actions that we have created. Now, press that icon to expand and display all the actions. Then choose whichever action that you'd like for the Gear S to show. For this application, we use the following functions: clock, keyboard, call, and message. On top of the list is the clock. Tapping this would open the clock application. When you tap the keyboard, it would open up the on-screen keyboard as an input tool. You have the option to use the onboard keyboard or another compatible keyboard. By pressing call, you can use either a static information that you have coded or have the application open up a number pad to edit the number. The next and last function is message. This would open up the message application and the keyboard, enabling you to create and send text messages. In the middle of the Gear S screen, you can see an Android icon. When you tap the icon, it would open the application installed in the device. With this example, we can open the Hello Rich Notification sample, which would send another rich notification back to the Gear S. Let's sum up the things we've discussed and curated in this episode. These are the things that we need to remember: to always include the SDK jar files in the project, include the important manifest permissions, and finally, always end the service when it is not in use. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Thanks for watching.